Hello friends, welcome back on my YouTube channel, and today I'm gonna show you how you can integrate Paytm SDK within your app, right guys? In the development phase we face multiple times a problem, that is a Paytm SDK integration. And whenever we try to integrate the Paytm with our app, we face a lot of problems, right? So I also faced a lot of problems, but after that I found the solution. And I thought ki why not we have to create a video for the audience for iOS SDK integration with Paytm SDK, right? So guys, today I'm gonna show you how you can integrate, right? So before that, before I start the integration, I have one request. If you like my video, then kindly press the like button and subscribe button, and also press the bell button. And if you have any query related to this video, you can comment in the comment box. Okay, so let's get started. So guys, before doing the integration, we will have to understand the working flow of Paytm checkout, right? So guys, if you go on the official website of Paytm developers, that is developer.paytm.com, I will drop the link in the description, right? So you can see the whole process. What is the process of it is following while integrating our Paytm SDK to our app, right? iOS app. So guys, first of all, in the step one, it is saying kindly collect the information from the customer, like what is the amount they want to pay to you. Okay, so whatever the transaction detail you want to get, so get from your app. And after that, in the second step, what you will do, you're gonna create, or you're gonna generate checksum from your backend server, right guys? It's not from your Paytm server, it's gonna generate checksum from your backend server. So whenever the checksum is generated, the step three comes, in which so whatever the checksum is generated and whatever the payloads are there, payloads in the sense ki transaction details, so you will have to pass those transactions and checksum to SDK in the step 3, right? So come over the step 4. So as you can see, in step 4 there is a SDK render payment page, okay? So in which you will be rendered to a payment page where you can enter your credit card number, debit card number, net banking, UPI, or maybe a wallet mobile number, right? So guys, after step 4, the step 5 comes, it will redirect it to your bank page, right, where you will enter your ATM pin or OTP, right? So after step 5, there is a step 6, in which communication transaction, so what, whatever the details has been got from our bank page, that is transferred to SDK, right? And transaction status also to SDK in the step 6. So in step 7, the transaction status communicates with our app, with our app, actually transferred to our app, right? And whenever the transaction details come on our backend server in the step 8, on the backend server, our backend server will verify the checksum, okay? And if the transaction is not tampered, then step 9 comes, in which you gonna request for transaction status, whether transaction status is pending, confirm, okay? So if the transaction status is confirmed, step 10 is come, so verify the order value and transaction status once again. And in the step 11, you gonna show the confirmation of payment, okay guys, to your customer. So this is the whole process how the Paytm works, right? So guys, before we gonna start, you will have to log in, you will have to create your account, or you will have to log in if you have already an account on developer.paytm.com, right? So there is a SDK integration, you know what guidelines are there, or all over the process, how is it working, okay? So, and I'm gonna drop the link also in description, so you can reach from that there. And so guys, before starting, we will need something backend server, right? From where you can generate the checksum, right? So that you can request for payment to Paytm, okay? So guys, for backend server, I'm gonna use MAMP, Okay, so MAMP is the popular server for PHP development process, right? So guys, you can install it freely, that is MAMP server. So guys, I have already installed, and after that you will need to write the code for generate checksum. Actually guys, you don't need to write the code for generate checksum. Actually Paytm already provide the code, right? And that is our Paytm app checksum kit PHP. Okay guys, so I'm gonna drop the link in description, you can reach from there, right? So, and you can read out the installation steps also. So it provides the whole code to generate checksum and verify checksum, and so you will have to clone or download this project. So let's download it. So I have already downloaded. So after downloading, you will have to configure your server, right? So after the installation of MAMP, you will have to on your MAMP. So guys, as you can see, after opening the MAMP software, you will look at this interface, in which you can click on the start servers. So when you click on the start servers, it's gonna start your Apache server and MySQL server. Okay, so guys, as you can see, whenever it's gonna start, the Apache server and MySQL server as a green indication. Okay, so it's gonna green indication, and there is a MAMP start page, right? So guys, if you go on the my website link, then it's gonna show you what websites you have deployed on this server, right? So because we don't have any website right now, we don't have any PHP page. So now I'm gonna deploy the checksum code on this server, right? And then we will access that generated checksum from this server to our app. Okay guys, so let's get start. So first of all guys, go in the Finder, go in the applications, and there will be a MAMP folder in which you will get a htdocs folder, right? So this is the guys, as this is our root directory, right, from where the checksum generation PHP file will be there. We will put right now. Okay, so from there the PHP file will be executed, right? So guys, first of all we need to download this Paytm app checksum kit PHP, right? You can download, it is available for Java also, right? So in the many languages it provides the checksum generation technique, right? So you will need a server, and you will need a PHP code or Java code or whatever code you want, right? So in the case of Java, there will be another server, like whatever the server they support. So guys, okay, let's start. So guys, let me download it. So I have already downloaded it. So guys, after downloading, okay, so downloads. So guys, as you can see, I have already downloaded this folder, and this is the folder. So let's rename it and give a short name, right? Like I'm gonna say PHP. Okay, let's take it as PHP only. And this is the folder in which there are some files like verify checksum.php, generate checksum.php. So I'm not gonna through the code, whatever the code in these files. Okay, just you need to do what, you just need to copy it. You will just need to copy it and go on htdocs and paste it here. Okay guys, so after pasting, you will need to configure your one file, that is in the lib directory, that is config.paytm.php. okay guys, so go on the config.paytm.php, and there will be Paytm merchant key. So it required a Paytm merchant key. So guys, if you want the Paytm merchant key, then go on again Chrome. So guys, as we know, this is the home page for developer, developer.paytm.com. For getting, so guys, how you can get your, okay, so let me check. Okay, I have already a link, I will drop in the description, in the video description guys. So if from the API keys guys, you can get, okay, so let me show you. So guys, these are the API keys, and this is the test merchant ID, and this is the test account secret key guys. Okay, so remember this point. So whenever you gonna copy and paste, what we need to copy paste here, Paytm merchant key. Okay guys, so it is asking about Paytm merchant key, not Paytm merchant ID. So be careful about this, because I have made the mistake. I have copied my merchant ID and paste there. That's why the checksum was not matched with the Paytm server, right? So I was faced many times this problem. So guys, be careful about this. You will have to copy the secret key, okay? So let's copy the secret key. After copy, come on the config paytm.php and paste it here within single quotes, okay? So be careful about this operation, right? And save it. So guys, after saving it, go on your MEM server, click on the open web start page. It is already running, right? So click on your my website. So guys, as I have already told, so whatever the files you are gonna put in the stdocs folder, that gonna execute from here, right? So my website, from my websites. So guys, as you can see, there is an index of, and there is our folder, PHP folder. Click on this, and as you can see, there is a generate checksum folder, file. So click on it. As you can see, the checksum is generated. Okay, but this is generated on our Chrome, and it should be retrieved from our app, right? So what I'm gonna do? This is my server. This is my whole server code. Page, right? So I want to access this server, and I want to execute this page on my app, right? So that I can get the checksum has. So guys, for that I have already created a project, a dummy project, right? So there is a dummy project. The name is Paytm payment integration. I will put this whole project on the GitHub, and I will drop the link in the description. Okay, so you can download the whole project. So guys, what we want to do, we want to access our backend server, right? So we need to perform the networking operations, right? So for that, I have already installed a pod, that is AlamoFire. Okay, so this is a very popular for networking operations. So as you, I think you know very well about this. Okay guys, so after installation of AlamoFire, and there is a main storyboard. So guys, there is a button, pay 10 rupees. So whenever I will click on the pay 10 rupees, it's gonna start the Paytm payment process. Okay guys, for 10 rupees. There may be your interface, like a shopping cart or whatever interface you want to design. Okay, and there is a view controller for that particular view controller, whatever we have designed in the main storyboard. So there is a action button, that is our pay button clicked. Okay, so named as a pay button clicked. And okay guys, sorry for disturbance, actually I paused the video, again the noise problem was there. Okay guys, okay, let's resume the things. Okay, so guys, there is a action, that is a pay button clicked. Okay, so whenever user gonna click on the pay button, the whole process of payment will be gonna start. Okay, so guys, okay, fine. So guys, we have already installed AlamoFire, okay, and everything is okay. So project, our project is set up completely. Now guys, I already written down all the steps, whatever we gonna follow, right? So I have already a note so that we can reduce the length of video, okay? And so guys, first of all, we require a AlamoFire port, so we have already done. Now guys, you will need a payment SDK, sorry, Paytm iOS AppKit SDK we will need. Okay, so I have the link also, I will drop in the description. You can go and you can download iOS SDK. Okay, so guys, just go on the web browser. Whenever you will click on that link, you're gonna see this interface. Okay, this interface. So guys, as you can see, there is already SDK, Paytm SDK for your iOS integration. Okay, actually when you will see the home page, it's gonna show you the Objective-C code, right? But if you go in the Swift folder, there is one SDK for Swift also. Okay, so what you will need to do, you will need to download this whole code, and after that you will go in the Swift directory after downloading. And after downloading, Paytm iOS AppKit. So guys, there is a Swift directory. In Swift directory there will be two folders, bytecode enabled and bytecode disabled, right? So you can choose one of them. So guys, after choosing, okay, you will need to import this thing into your Xcode. Okay, so let me import this thing. So I have imported, and so guys, as you can see, the Paytm SDK framework is there, right? Now the next step, guys, be careful about this step, in which you're gonna see we will need to import that Paytm SDK framework into our embedded binaries and linked frameworks and binaries, right? So in the both things, you will need to import this. So let me import Paytm SDK framework. So guys, there is a repetition, let me remove one. Okay guys, so our Paytm SDK framework has been imported successfully, guys. So let me close this tab. Okay. So guys, almost we are done with the setup. Okay, so let's go on the next step. What is the next step? Let me show you. So the next step is, guys, we will need to write a WS manager. Basically, WS manager is a web service manager from where we gonna call the APIs, right? So there, in this file, basically in this file, there will be a class and there will be a function. That function we gonna use to call the network operations. Okay guys, so let me import this file also. Actually, I already done the code for the LMFire request. Okay, so guys, there is a, okay, let me copy it. So there is a WS manager. So in this WS manager, actually there are some constraints are there, and basically I use this file in the many projects, because this file is independent. You know what, only this function is required to call any kind of API, and it's gonna convert that JSON response into corresponding model. Okay, so guys, this is the function, and this function is generic as decodable. So, and this, there is a success model. So whenever I'm gonna call this function, I will call the success, I will pass something in the success handler. So guys, whatever type of value you're gonna pass in the response in the success handler, that will be treated as the type of D. Okay, so guys, as you can see, there is a code for JSON decoder and decode, and it's gonna convert the JSON response into a particular model. Okay guys, so whatever the type you gonna pass in the success handler, that type will be used here. Okay, so response data will be converted into your corresponding model. Okay, now guys, be careful here, there is an encoding method. Okay, so what is there, as you can see, I have configured the LMFire also here, and in this function basically I'm gonna create the LMFire request. Okay, okay, so as you know how you can use the LMFire request, right? So I'm not gonna in deep. Okay, but you will need to keep one thing in mind, the encoding type should be your encoding dot default instead of JSON, your JSON encoding dot default or any other you are going to use, because this creates a problem. Okay, basically this creates a problem for me multiple times. Okay, that's why I'm saying. Okay, so just keep it as UL encoding as default. Okay, so guys, this is the second step, and after that we gonna create some constraints for our file. Okay, so let's create the constraints. So guys, for the constraints, I'm gonna create a new file, and that new file I'm gonna name it as constant. Okay, so I'm gonna name it as constants, and there I'm gonna create my Paytm constants. Okay, so Paytm constants, actually while creating the transaction details, we need some constants like MID, what is your merchant ID. So in my case, this is like this, what is the channel ID, industry type ID, website is web staging, okay, callback URL. And now we'll need to create one model also, because as we know, whenever we gonna hit our backend server, it's gonna return the checksum, and with checksum it's gonna return some other details like order ID and PT status. Okay guys, so we created a model so that whatever the JSON response is coming from our backend server, we gonna store in this model. Okay, so let me create this model also. So let me create one new more file, so Swift file. Okay, so guys, okay, let me rename it as checksum model. Okay, so this is the file, and I'm gonna put the structure also here. Okay, so checksum model is there. Okay, so now next step is what, guys? I need to create some instance variables in my view controller. Okay, so let me copy it, go in our view controller, and there is our instance variables are there, right? Okay, guys, so now come to the first of all, I need to import Paytm SDK also. So guys, let me import it. Okay, so I have imported the Paytm SDK. Okay guys, we have imported our Paytm SDK. Okay, so after import the Paytm SDK, okay, so what is the next step, guys? So before going on the next step, I want to tell you one thing. This is our constant files, right guys? So guys, in the constant file you will need the MID, that is will be our merchant ID. So how will you get? Again, go on the just as I already told you, there is a test account secret key, and there is also a merchant ID, right? So you will have to use this merchant ID in the testing scenario or in the development scenario, but whenever your product is completed, you will have to activate your account from here. Okay, so when you activate your account and you gonna submit the details of your company, of your app, so guys, in that case you will get the production API details. Are you getting my point? So this is the testing purpose only, the merchant ID or secret key. If you activate your account in the production phase, you will get another merchant ID and secret key. Okay guys, so for now I'm gonna use this merchant ID. Okay, so I have already copied it, and in the Xcode, in the position of MID, you will paste your whatever your merchant ID, you will paste here. Okay, so guys, channel ID will be the same as WAP. Okay, so guys, if you go on the Paytm iOS SDK, and there are few steps in which they told how you will integrate the Paytm. So guys, they are using the channel ID as WAP, and we are also using WAP. Okay, and the industry type ID, I'm gonna use retail, and the website I'm gonna use web staging. So guys, they are also using web staging. Okay guys, okay, fine. And there is a callback URL, so callback URL will be like this. Okay, so callback URL will be like this, and you will have to append with this string, you will have to append your order ID also, right? So I'm not gonna doing here, this thing I will do in my view controller. Okay guys, so these are the constants which I'm gonna use. So let's go on the view controller, and guys, there are some instance variable we have created, that is our checksum model and PG transaction view controller, that will be our payment gateway transaction view controller, and the server environment. Okay, so guys, go on the next step. Next, what is the next step? Okay, in the view did appear, we need to write this code. Okay, so let me first of all let me override my view did appear. Okay, so view did appear. Okay, so guys, this is my view did appear method, and in this method I'm gonna copy and paste this code. Okay, and then I will show you what is the role of this code. Okay, so guys, there is a order ID, and the order ID will be generated as random. Okay, so I'm gonna create one more function, that is a random string function, and it's gonna generate some random strings so that every time our order ID and customer ID should be unique. Because if you gonna send the same order ID and customer ID every time, the checksum won't be generated, guys. Be careful about this. If you are using the order ID and customer ID in the transaction as same, then you will face the checksum mismatch problem. Okay guys, so don't do this kind of things. Be careful, and these two things should be random string. Okay guys, and guys, as you can see, there are some parameters. We have created a dictionary params, and we have put some parameters, that is our MID. So I'm gonna use my MID from our Paytm constants. Have you remember, in the constant file we have created our constants? Okay, so I'm gonna use that MID, and the order ID is generated here, guys. Okay, so randomly, and the customer ID is there, so you can use mobile number or email. These are the optional things. If you use, then fine. If you are not using, then also fine. Okay, no matter you are using or not. Okay, so guys, next is your channel ID. So channel ID again I'm gonna use as web. Okay, so next is industry type ID. So again I'm gonna use from constants website. And so guys, website is what, website is our web staging. So guys, be careful about this, and this is only for the testing purpose. If you go in the production detail, guys, this almost will be changed, like industry type ID will be changed after the activation of your account, and website will not be web staging, it will be something different. Okay, so guys, this thing is there. Okay, so guys, let's again, there is a transaction amount and the callback eval. So guys, callback eval, as you can see, I have used from the constant file, but I am appending my order ID also. Okay guys, up to now I think everything is clear. Okay, there is no hard thing. And guys, there is a function, that is a random string function, and that gonna generate the random strings. Okay, so guys, next step is what, I'm gonna create a function that will be our generate checksum API call, and this gonna call our backend server. Okay guys, our backend server, not Paytm server. Means our backend server means what, if we go here, so this URL we want to hit. Okay, and with this URL, what we can get our checksum, guys. Okay, so guys, there are two ways to generate checksums. It provides the default checksum, or default in the sense ki it's gonna use your secret key and it's gonna generate the checksum. Okay, so instead of doing this, we can pass some parameters, and on the basis of that parameters, it's gonna create checksum. Okay, checksum has. So guys, how we can pass, let me create first of all that function. So guys, what is the function? This is the function, guys, get checksum API call. Okay, so what I'm gonna do here, I'm gonna create a variable that is that will be app struct type. Okay, so what is the app struct, API struct? It's nothing, guys, it's a, you know what, combination of some properties like URL, method and body, which will be used in our LMFI request, right? So for our request, what is the URL, what is the method, what is the body? Okay, means parameters which you want to pass. Okay, so guys, and okay, let me comment this line first of all. So guys, I have created the API struct, means I have created a, you know what, model, a simple model in which there is a URL and method. So guys, I'm gonna call my WS manager. Have you remember WS manager? We have created a file WS manager in which there is a class WS manager, and that class is singleton, and there was a method that is a get JSON response. Okay, so in this get JSON response, if we go on this, it is asking about API struct, object, success handler and a failure handler. Okay guys, so there is a API struct model we gonna pass, in which the URL will be like this. Okay guys, so guys, now be careful here, replace this thing by your IP address. Okay, So this thing will be your IP address. So what is your IP address? How will you know? Go on the terminal, type if config. Okay, so if you type if config in the EN0 or EN1, if you are using the LAN, you can see in your EN0. If you are using the Wi-Fi, then you can see your IP address in the EN1. Okay guys, so this is my IP address, as you can see, 192.168.43.136. Okay guys, so let me replace by this. Okay, 192.168.43.136. And you will have to put the colon and you will have to put your port number also. Okay guys, so what is the port number? As you can see here, so our server is running on this port, right? So guys, I think you are understanding. Okay, and there is no very complex things. Okay, very simple things are there. And so guys, it's gonna return me what? Checksum. Okay, so let's call first of all this get checksum API call from by clicking on this button. Okay, so let's see whether it is generating the checksum or not. So I have already running the simulator and now run. Okay, let me run this code and see whether it is generating the checksum or not, API is hitting successfully or not. Okay, guys, as you can see, our app is successfully up and running. Now click on the pay 10 rupees and what is the error here, guys? What is the mistake here? Let me check. Load failed. And okay guys, there is a problem, that is this is not the HTTPS request, this will be your HTTP request, because you are using your local machine as server, right? So it will be your HTTP request. And guys, whenever you gonna hit an HTTP request, you will need to configure your info.plist also. Okay, so guys, you will have to go in the info plist and you will click on this plus icon and you will have to write app transport security settings. And okay, so now you will have to click on this plus icon and you will write, is there anything else? Okay, let me show you. First of all, remove this. Okay, and click on this. Okay, you will have to write allow arbitrary loads and you will have to mark it as yes. Okay, so let me write it as yes instead of no. Okay, second. So guys, we have done with info plist. Let's go back. And guys, now let's again hit our server, our backend server. Okay, so let's hit our backend server once again. So let me run my application and check whether is it giving me checksum or not. Okay, let's run and check. So guys, our application is up and running. Okay, now click on the pay 10 rupees. Oops, it is showing something went wrong. Okay guys, what is the problem? Let me check the URL. So what is the URL on our local server? Let me go on the URL. Okay guys, there is a URL problem actually. So let me copy the URL from here to here. Let's copy it, go on your Xcode and change this part of URL. Okay guys, from this part. Okay, actually I have copied the code and that's why the problem is there. Okay, so guys, let's run and check whether is it working or not. So guys, I hope this time it will work fine. Okay, so guys, click on the pay 10 rupees and now the callback is there and let's print the API struct model. Okay guys, so as you can see on the success, it's gonna put the data into checksum model. Okay, so I'm gonna put print checksum model. So guys, as you can see, it is returning something in the checksum model. Okay, so guys, as you can see, there is a checksum, there is a order ID and there is a PT status. Okay guys, so up to now everything is good, fine. So our checksum is generated. Now the next thing is only what we need to present our transaction view controller. Okay guys, so for that, once again go in the notes and as you can see, there is a function that is set up Paytm function. Okay guys, so let me copy this function and let me paste it here. So guys, this is the code for your Paytm setup. Okay, what is the problem here? Okay, it is saying we can't set this class as a delegate for PG transaction delegate. Okay guys, so let me copy the delegates also. So these are the delegates methods, and okay, so let me copy, and guys, let me create the extension of this class. So what is my class? My class is view controller. Okay guys, so let me write view controller. Okay, and paste my code. Okay, so guys, now this is the PG transaction delegate. Okay, so I think error is removed. Yep. So guys, in the setup Paytm, what we are gonna do, actually we are creating our staging server environment. Okay, so guys, for right now, because we are working on the testing, we are in the development phase, so we will use e-server types as a staging. Okay, next we are gonna create a order model with blank order ID, customer ID, amount. Okay, but don't worry, in the params, as you can see in the order params, we gonna initialize our OR params. Okay, have you remember we have created these params? Okay, on the basis of these params, as you can see, params has been passed here. On the basis of these params, we have generated our checksum. Okay, and we are gonna use these params also in the order. Okay, so whatever the order ID, customer ID will be extracted from our params. And one more thing guys, in the case of creation of order, you will have to pass the checksum also. Okay, so have you remember we have got the checksum here. So what I'm gonna do here, I'm gonna call this method, that is setup Paytm method, and I'm gonna pass the checksum and params also. Okay, so let me call this function from here, because we are gonna get our checksum here. So guys, I'm gonna extract my checksum from the checksum model, and I'm gonna pass the params also. So after passing these things, the transaction controller is going to be open. The title will be like this, logging will be enabled, and our whatever the server type is there, we are initializing, and there is a merchant configuration, that will be our default configuration. So I have set my delegate, and now guys, I'm gonna push view controller, that is our transaction controller. So guys, because we gonna push, so there should be a navigation controller also in our main storyboard. So let me go on main storyboard, and let me embed this view controller into our in the navigation view controller. Okay, so this is my navigation controller. Okay, it is embedded successfully. Okay guys, so let's go on the view controller once again, and so guys, we are on the view controls. Okay, so guys, after this, only that this thing you need to understand is delegates. Okay, so guys, there are some delegates. Let me remove first of all this code so that you can clearly understand. And there are some delegate methods like did finish response, did cancel transaction, and error missing parameters. You know what, and these kinds of scenarios are there. And okay, and is there any, okay, one more curly braces is required. Okay, so guys, as you can see, so if the response is coming successful, then the callback will be there. If the transaction is cancelled, the callback will be there, and if the parameters are missing, the callback here, right? So guys, and now in the finished response, I'm gonna put some code. So what is the code here? I'm gonna extract my response string. So whatever the response string is coming, I'm gonna extract, and I'm gonna extract the data as data. Okay, and the encoding type I have defined, and now I'm gonna serialize that JSON data. Okay, so from that JSON, I'm gonna extract my status. Okay, so after the serialization of JSON serialization, the data will be in the dictionary format. Okay, in this variable. So I'm gonna extract the status, and that will be our title message. Okay, so I'm gonna create one action seat controller, and so actually I'm gonna show the alert message. Okay, so because we are gonna use the alert controller, so on the alert message there will be a title, and whatever the content is coming in the form of JSON, I'm gonna print. Okay, so let me run this app and show you how is it working. Okay, so guys, our app is up and running. Now click on the pay 10 rupees and guys, okay, so our callback is there. Okay, let me run further. Okay, so guys, as you can see, it is redirecting to our Paytm payments page. Okay, so let it be redirected. So guys, redirection has been successfully. As you can see, there is a Paytm payments page, okay, on which you can log in with your wallet or by using credit card, debit card. Okay, so I'm gonna use the net banking, so I'm clicking on the net banking. So guys, because the app is in the staging server, so there are some predefined credentials are there for testing purpose only. Okay, how will you get? Just go on your dashboard where you have logged in, and as you can see, there is a testing integration. So if you click on this, you're gonna redirect it to this test instruments. Okay, so in the test instruments, as you can see, there are some dummy data for your transactions. Okay, so I'm gonna use net banking, and the net banking will be Andhra Bank. Test will be the password. Now guys, there is a problem, and the password test, the T is not capital. Actually, it is showing in the doc as capital, but whenever you gonna transaction, doing the transaction, it's not, it will not be in the capital, it should be small. Okay, small case letter. Okay, so let me click on the Andhra Bank and click on the pay now. So guys, it, as you can see, it is redirected to our Andhra Bank networking page. Okay, so let me come on this page. Okay, zoom it, and so guys, the user ID is, as we have discussed, it is test. So let me enter it as test. Okay, okay, so guys, it will be test, and the password will be also test. Okay, and okay, so click on the login. So guys, as you can see, it is redirecting to pay, confirmation page. So okay guys, as you can see, our Paytm payments view controller, on the Paytm payments view controller, there is a pop-up with your transaction success. So basically, this is the title which we have got here, where I think in the delegates. Okay, so yep, so guys, as you can see, there is a message, title message. So we have extracted that status and we have printed that status. Okay guys, so if you click on the OK button, it's gonna redirect it to your view controller. Okay, so guys, I hope you have understand all over the scenario, all over the code. Now guys, I'm gonna tell you some key points where commonly we mistakes while the integration. Okay, so what are the key points? So guys, whenever you are using the constants, be careful about these constants. So guys, these constants should be same as whatever the data is predefined, like MID should be same. So whatever the MID, that should be here, right? And the channel ID should be WAP in the case of staging. Okay, and the industry type should be retail. Website should be web staging, not WAP staging. Okay, it should be web staging and not app staging, because somewhere I have seen in the blog or somewhere I have seen they have used app underscore staging, but I think that is not working right now, and I have used the web staging, so it is working fine. Okay, so the callback URL should be like this, not like this. Okay, in the many videos or in the many blogs I have seen they used callback URL as like this, right? But it's not working for me. It's working for me. Okay guys, so this is the and don't forget to add your order ID also with this callback URL. So whenever you are going to use callback URL somewhere, you will have to append your order ID also. Okay, and so this is the key points where I did the mistake. And one more thing, you will have to remember one more thing, that is your URL. Okay, so guys, whenever you are writing your URL, kindly cross check it multiple times. Okay, So because our server is on the local machine, then in case if you are testing this app on your physical device, then your physical device and your local system, this Mac on which your server is running, both should be on the same network, means both should be connected with the same network, then only it's gonna work, otherwise it's not gonna work. Okay guys, you can create your server on the global also, like 000 web host is the website which provides free web hosting, okay, for with limited things. Okay, so guys, you can use that 000 website, or you can create your system as server. Okay, so guys, this is the second mistake which I have done multiple times. And guys, one more thing, your order ID and customer ID should be random. And guys, what the mistake? Okay, checksum should be appended here. So whenever you're gonna open your transaction view controller, checksum should be appended with your predefined params. Okay, so remember this thing also. I think guys, only these things are required. You will have to be careful about it. Okay, so guys, I hope I was able to show you and I was able to teach you how you can integrate Paytm payments with your app. Okay, so guys, if you like my work, if you are liking my style of telling you things, okay, then kindly like my video, hit the like button, hit the subscribe button and hit the bell icon. Okay, because if you want the new videos and if you want the new updates related to my videos, okay, so you can get by pressing the bell button. And guys, please, if you have any query related to this video, you can comment in the comment section. Okay guys, so guys, tell me how is my work. And okay, fine. So this thing is I think enough for this video. Okay guys, bye bye, take care, like, share and subscribe my video. Okay, and subscribe my channel. Thank you.